together. But thank you for joining me this morning. Hope you've enjoyed so far.
Very much so.
Thank you for having us.
It's a pleasure. Absolutely delighted. Delighted. So I think it'd be good to kick off with the actual agenda question for you guys, because I think it's such an important topic right now. And yeah, I'm really keen to hear your view on it. So Ben, if I kick off with you, how do you see brands building meaningful relationships with consumers, especially at this time?
Yeah, absolutely. I think, you know, right now it's certainly a very, very interesting period. And I think right now there's a lot of obviously negativity within the news, just understandably about, you know, what's going on with the situation. So I think right now people are sort of like welcoming distractions. They're welcoming messages which can add that bit of positivity, and they can add that, you know, bit of message which will raise morale as such. And I think that's where creators are perfectly placed to be able to do that, essentially. Though with that in mind, for those who haven't read the BBH COVID-19 and marketing report, I would actively encourage you to. I posted it on my LinkedIn a few days ago, but essentially what it's trying to say is, with that in mind, brands trying to raise morale, be very careful about how you do it. And I think the biggest message here is, don't be opportunist. And also be real, and be kind and be calm. And with that in mind as well, I think people right now will remember how brands are portraying themselves to consumers. I've seen a couple of fashion brands try and be a little bit cheeky, I would say, and try and do messages where, you know, they're promoting perhaps like, you know, custom like face masks and things like that. And it doesn't necessarily portray a great image. But I've seen brands who've, you know, spread some really positive messages, and, you know, consumers will remember that. And that's, I think, why, as I mentioned earlier, that they're steering towards the creators to help do that, because the creators have these engaged communities, and the creators can help spread that positivity.
That's really powerful. And I think it's really nice of you to recap, actually, to remind everybody the rules of engagement, they're real right now. And getting it, I think getting the tone of voice right is it's a deal breaker, isn't it? I mean, it means the brand resonates or not. And I think we're going to see that with influencers, with how, with the influencers that do well in space.
100%. And what we're also seeing as well, which is quite interesting, is how brands are also looking after creators within the community as well. So I think, you know, obviously creators right now, it's, you know, no hidden secret that advertisers are, you know, pausing spends, they're delaying spends. So what we are seeing though is some brands coming out to support creators, whereby perhaps it's not their traditional message of outward pushing, perhaps like some travel brands. But they're helping to support those creators who they'd be previously working with on trips and whatnot, but to portray other messages, which I think is fantastic to see within the industry.
That's actually really heartwarming. And that's a purpose as well, and doesn't need to be something we necessarily see, but that's where the community element comes into play, doesn't it, between the brand and the content creator, which is really brilliant. And so are you seeing, actually, that I guess brings me on to my next question, are you seeing a change in narrative from your content creators?
Yeah, so I think the three biggest shifts we're sort of seeing at the moment is, for sure, there are some advertisers who are still, you know, keen on going live, often with content which is being created before obviously everything hit. And what we're tending to encourage is that the creators just add a little bit of a disclaimer to say that this content was created before, not to promote any sort of, you know, negative behavior or to encourage any negative sentiment around what the content actually portrays at the moment. So we are seeing disclaimers added. What we're also seeing as well is a big shift in branded content from our creators. So with production shoots up and down the country being cancelled, what we're seeing is brands needing content assets now more than ever, and who better than, you know, your content creators. So we're seeing creators not necessarily just get commissioned to post on their own channels, but to produce assets which advertisers can use for paid social, you know, to be put through their premium publishers as well. So we're seeing a huge rise in demand in that. And then lastly, just in terms of what the creators are actually saying when they are still posting, you know, obviously there are some advertisers who we work with, like, you know, we work with ride hailing apps, and unfortunately those ones it has to be a little bit parked with their advertising. But there are other ones where there are fashion brands who have been quite innovative, and whether that be, you know, a campaign around showing what's in their wardrobe at home, for example, the creators, and that's getting, you know, really positive sentiments. That's something which we're tracking at the moment very heavily, is the sentiment around campaigns and seeing how consumers are actively responding. And we are seeing, you know, consumers being very positive to creators who are being sensitive with their posts, and they are, you know, very like almost like proud of their creators still being managed to work with the brands during this difficult time.
That's really powerful. I think that's just really, I think getting the whole message there is amazing. And of course, you know, this is where you see real winners and losers. We talk about it's quite concerning for anybody who's out in the field when it comes to production, but a huge opportunity when the producers do that from their own homes, such as the influencers, which is amazing. Jane, can I put a question your way, actually, thinking about that? Brands call their marketing spend into question a couple of weeks ago. Has this remained the case? Are you seeing the brands are spending again? What's kind of, what's the temperature of spend that you're seeing?
I think, well, the temperature seems to be changing all the time, but...
like the weather.
Yeah, pretty much. Snow and then sunshine this week alone. So yeah, I mean, obviously a couple of weeks ago, we had a lot of clients and brands discussing with us the options of what should we do? You know, there was a lot of consternation and a lot of immediate halting of activity. However, what I think that gave brands and clients a time to do is for reflection and to also work with us and really understand how do we actually help consumers during this very concerning time? So I think what we see now is a lot of reactivation, but with different messaging, really sort of getting our advice on how we can tap into, as Scott said, the people that we work with, our creators, you know, they really have got this great active audience. So how do we utilize that even more so during a very stressful time? And of course, some activations will be delayed, and working with those brands to make sure that when we can reactivate, we can do that in a really efficient way. Also, interestingly for us, I suppose we've seen a lot of new types of brand and activity where potentially we wouldn't normally have seen some of that activity now. So where brands can really support and help the consumer, whether it be wellness at home. Obviously, we talked earlier about the boom in online fitness and well-being, but also how you help parents during this time. I mean, I'm not a parent, but I've got lots of friends who are looking after children at home, dealing with the school holidays that are about to happen. How do you, you know, engage children, helping them still with their education? So a lot of new activations as well, but also just a constant dialogue. As we said earlier, the temperature is changing all the time.
Yes.
How do we deal with the new normal for now, and how do brands have an always on activation to really engage? Is a great opportunity, as Ben said and Scott referred to really engage with your brand and really get great brand loyalty through a very, very tricky time.
That's really powerful. And then, like, you've touched on the categories, and so, like, one of the questions I was thinking, is there a trend in the spend category? But is it really around the wellness and the parenting, or are you seeing other?
No, I don't think there's a trend. There's obviously, people have big anxieties right now around wellness, finance, family, entertainment at home. So I don't think there's a trend in sector. There's a trend in messaging, and there's a trend in how you engage with your consumers during a complete shift in consumer habits and also a shift in consumer mindset. So I don't think it's a sector trend. It's more of a messaging trend and how you can really, you know, do stuff for good and really do it for good. You know, make sure that your messaging is really, really helping consumers through a bad time.
Dude, that's really powerful when you think about, we're talking about social purpose here, and we're talking about brands spending through this, and some brands knowing what to do and other brands maybe not. But I guess with you advising them, and actually for brand to think differently, don't think about your sector, think about the messaging that people need and how do you bring that message with your brand, which is really brand values. And I guess finding influencers who can, you know, who can create that content or tell that narrative. So that's a really powerful way of looking at it.
Exactly. And as Ben said, a lot of brands wanting to still work with creators. And so really, and so, you know, our whole ethos is about building meaningful relationships between brands and creators. And this gives us an opportunity to do this in a way that can be really, really helpful for everybody in that sort of ecosystem.
Really good. And do you find then you have to pull in, is that a new team, or is just really your team are already really well versed in it? Because that's a real hand-holding for the client, or shift, helping them shift in their thinking, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, it's always been something in our structure that we've done all along, and Ben will refer to how we do that as a team.
Yeah, and actually, Ben, maybe, yeah, I'll actually jump to you with this question, because that kind of, my segue is kind of, are you seeing many brands pivot their business?
Yeah, I mean, just to, I guess, add on to a little bit of what Jane just said about the strategy element, I think something which we've always been really proud of at Influencer is, for sure, we have all that, you know, intelligent global data from our platform, and, you know, we invest very heavily within our insights. So we recently hired the ex-director of data science from Kantar as our head of insights to help really, you know, be relevant and understand what's currently going on within the market.
Amazing.
But that has to be kind of, you know, have a layer of human creativity on the top. So our strategy team is something which we've been investing in heavily as well over the last sort of 6 months. And, you know, with that, you know, strategy piece comes, okay, well, how can we adjust to these current situations and use the data to all back it up? I mean, you know, we have clients like Pernod Ricard's a big account for us. And Pernod Ricard right now have stopped production of, for example, their Absolut Vodka, because what they've done is they've changed that production line to actually make hand sanitizer, which is fantastic. So, you know, it's been adding value to a situation, but of course that means that they're no longer interested in advertising Absolut Vodka, but, you know, it's brands adapting. And as long as they're adding value to consumers, then, as I sort of mentioned earlier, you know, consumers will remember. It's about showing your true colors right now, especially, you know, in these times. So I think that's what brand, you know, consumers will definitely remember. But I guess as well, just to answer further your question on creativity, we are, you know, being very mindful and being very sensitive to brands on the strategy piece, and we are helping them ensure that they are, as I mentioned earlier, be real, add clarity, and not being opportunist.
Yeah, I think that's really, really powerful. And actually, you think of like Pernod Ricard, and they're not, so the influencers would have been doing some amazing content around Absolut Vodka, but I guess it's not quite the same, or hand sanitizer. And that just makes me think, like, Ben, the question to you is, how are the influencers helping as a business?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we're sort of getting involved in three different ways at the moment. So of course, Scott brought it up earlier. You know, we're working with the World Health Organization as their influencer platform to help amplify the message. I know plenty of other influencer platforms are also getting involved, I think,
as
well, which is great to see. And it's about really during these times setting aside those differences and just all coming together to sort of amplify the message as far as possible. So that's something which we're working on. There's an article on it in The Drum. But we're also getting involved in two other ways. So tomorrow morning, actually, at 8:30 a.m., we've got a workout on our Instagram. So we've got one of our creators doing a little workout to help just kind of, you know, set the vibe for the morning, try and help with, like, mental health. So for anyone who wants to join in, it's just go to our Instagram. It's just the word influencer, and that's 8:30 a.m. tomorrow morning. And also attached to that as well, my co-founder, Casper, he's working with the NHS Charities Together on a massive campaign right now, trying to unify creators all around the world to help amplify more messages, just to help support and, you know, raise awareness and raise charity donations for the NHS.
That's really, really powerful, I have to say. And it's really, you know, it's really, really wonderful to hear when big businesses like you say, talk about the WHO campaign, and, you know, talk about competitors, not as competitors, but actually as a community as well. So that's a real pulling together, which is amazing. And then you as a business working with charities. So I think this is, it's an amazing, interesting time of watching how people change their behaviour. And again, we'll keep looking at this space, and I'm going to look at 8:30 tomorrow morning. Tempted to do some exercise. But thank you so much. That was absolutely brilliant. And I'll put this out to anybody questions. I can bring them through at the very end as well, because I'm going to